To be with you, Rush Limbaugh, the EIB Network, and...
Good morning, everybody.
Hello, friends. Welcome to the show.
What's up, beer drinkers? We got another great show for you again this week.
Here's Dan Hampton and Ed O'Brien.
Hey, it's Conrad Thompson, and you're listening to...
All right, you know why we're here. So if you have any doubts or reservations, now is the time to say so. No one will think any less of you. Because once you enter this family, there's no getting out.
This is where this gets difficult.
Mafia podcast. Faust, I really need like a post-it note. When I start to say it, I go, am I saying the right show? Oh, yes.
Remember, when you see Greg, you don't say wrestle. So somehow you
know, that's how I got to say it. I know Greg for cock, not tongue. So Lingus is the problem with that. Welcome to the cock show. I'm the boss of this fan. My name is Cab Manning. I'm along with the consigliere. That is Fausty Walnuts.
What do you hear? What do you say?
Our booker, our underboss, that is Gregorio.
Buonasera.
Oh, you can get all of our nonsense at Lingus Mafia on all socials. And you can go to patreon.com/Lingus Mafia to get this thing in video form, on time, all time, all the wrestling shows. $5, you get a ton of shit. And no commercials, yada, yada. So we're going to get into a show here. Multiple things are going on. We're going to get to the draft because we have finally gotten to one of my favorite times of year, Faust, because it's usually what I live for, because my season's fuck. I love football season, but it's a fucking always a shamble. So I live for the next, oh, look who I got. And I don't know the guy, you know, one of those things.
Right.
So I live for the draft.
Me and Greg actually get to tune in on Thursday for the first time in a couple of years.
Yeah, it's been a while since you had a first rounder. You know, giving them all up for, well, you had Trey. That was the last time, I guess, right? Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know if I want to get excited. Yeah.
Every once in a while, your team who does nothing wrong finally fucks up.
The last I heard is, well, they draft 31st. They said, we've graded out about 22 players worth a first round pick. So I don't know how that works out. I don't know if that means maybe they trade up or those guys fall to them.
I would say that means somebody's fucking up. Then you're sliding somewhere there.
Well, unlike last time, there's no pressure on them to hit on a 31st round or 31st overall pick.
Yeah. I mean, they already hit on the 198th or whatever the fuck that was.
262.
Yeah, there you go, kid. fuck. So yeah, we have that coming up, which me and Fausty got our draft hats. When did you get yours in the mail finally?
It took a while. It took like a couple of weeks.
Yeah, mine was
finally
like
showed up.
Mine was like 3 days or 4 days. And I'm like, oh, that's interesting because nobody's buying the Bears ones very quickly. we also, Greggy boy, we went golfing this weekend.
Oh yeah, where'd you go?
We went to the Copperopolis Copper Valley one. The one by me.
Oh,
so this was my area time. And it was me, our buddy Bush, and Fausty. And we go to this place, and it's one of those places you're intimidated when you drive to it. There's only been a couple of those places in my life where I go, oh, fuck. Like, it's gated. And And when you know it's class when you go, can I get a bucket of balls? And they go, a bucket? They look at you like you're an asshole. And they go, they're in like the pyramids down on the grass. You go.
Yeah, I was about to ask if it was pyramid.
Like, we'll split a bucket. There's a fucking pyramid, you fucking yokels. Get the fuck out of here.
And you know it's classy when it's free. The range is free. They're like, ah, we piss a fucking driving range.
Faust, it wasn't free or you had to pay for
it? No, it wasn't free.
You had to pay for stuff.
Oh, damn it.
You had to pay for going out there. And you rent the spot.
It was $10, I guess, for the smaller unlimited. Or whatever.
But it was unlimited balls, and you pay per where you're at.
That's what it
and
was,
you just keep on go as far right, as, long
we
as
gonna,
you want.
We were going to get a quick bite to eat because we were there about an hour early, and
game
then we were going to hit some balls.
At 3, and we were there about 2, yeah.
And then we heard, hey, we can get us in at 2, and we're like, well.
Yeah, because they're like, oh, we're going to eat, and then the lady was like, because at 3, it was only $75 instead of like $125 or something like that. And so the lady's like, oh, I can get you in at 210 or something. And I'm like, fuck, they went to get a hot dog. And I go, they took the bleachers out, Faust. They couldn't get a fucking hot dog there. They were behind. This is like a restaurant. Yeah, this is a restaurant. This is like a hardcore, like, people go there for dining. It's a fucking country club and shit.
They have tablecloths.
Yes, yes. It's a country club and it's gated community, people living in there. Health facility, the room, you know, all the fucking gym, the tennis court. This is country club.
Judge it's, Mills.
It's Larry David's, you know, with the fucking black swan. So they're like, oh, fuck. All right. It's going to take forever. And then the lady goes, because I go, they're getting the food. And she goes, oh, well, try to get in before 2:30 because there's a group going out at 2:30 that's never played before. And I drop your hot dog. Let's get the fuck go.
So we went back to the clubhouse, and Bush was like, "Hey, is it possible we get our $10 back for the range?
Well, yeah,
we're gonna go on early." And he's like, "Well," he goes, "actually, how much are these snacks over here? Like $3 each." He goes, "Just give me. Can I just take 3 and we'll call it even?"
Oh,
the guy's like, "Yeah, go ahead."
They were very kind to us because we said, "I go." Anyway, because we were going to draw straws who got the cart by themselves. And we're like, hey, I go, anyway, we can get 3 carts because the other guy's not showing up. And because I saved it for 4 in case, right? And he's like, you guys don't want to drive together? I go, well, why? Well, why would you want to? And I go, you know, we don't wash. So
keep the game a little faster.
Yeah, we move around. And he was like, he goes, just say you found the key in the cart down there. I never gave you nothing. And we're like, thank you.
What are you talking about?
It does, never hurts to ask, right?
No. So we gave it to him. He just says, just you found the key in the thing. So go ahead. And so we each have a cart. And now here's where you go, oh, my God. We get to the first tee. First of all, on the cart is a ball washer and a club washer on the cart. Mm-hmm. And you say, that's a fucking rarity. And, of course, you know you're a good place when it has electronic scoring and where to go and, you know, all that shit. Because usually, you know, you have nothing. And then on the other side is a cooler. So you go, okay, that's normal. I've seen that before. But now at the first tee, there's a thing full of you could scoop ice.
There's a trough.
And there's a trough of ice to scoop and put into the cooler. I go, what the fuck is going on? So every few, there's that. So you could load up, and so I'm like, I dump all my shit.
There was a water cooler. It felt like every other or every third hole. It felt like
signs that say no urinating. As Rob pisses on his side, yes. And, but then there's actual bathrooms though. There's not like, oh, I'm going forever before a bathroom. So they had bathrooms.
In the water coolers, did they have Avion?
Mine is it was Perrier. It was sparkling. So here's the thing, Greg. Ready for this is the wildest shit. So we were having a good game. I cannot praise. Let me give you your flowers because it's the gayest thing to ever say, Faust. Faust has gotten so much fucking better. Like, very much, like, a big improvement better.
Still can't win.
He still can't win, but I'm giving him 10. You know, listen. I mean, come on.
I'm cutting down on the bad shots.
Very much. So if I am really
still there.
If I do have a bad game, I'm losing the fucking game. And the thing, he gets 9.5 points, but this fucking thing comes down to, like, I go, it's a marathon, and he's always ahead because it's 9 points. I'm like, in the first, you know, 10 or whatever, you're still losing. So
yeah, I always look at it like, okay, five on the front, five on the back. So if like, if I'm within five, I'm like, well, it's still about even, you know? So if I'm already down like six or seven after nine, I'm like, well,
that's when it's, then it's the, let me put my foot on your throat time, but it's, he's up. And I'm like, I got to fucking start to catch it. So you start to think toward that back half, the back half. And you start to go, chisel away, take away one here. And like, just get ahead at one each time we can get there. We get down to, there's three holes left and Faust is up by four. And I said to him what I said to Bush that time. How much was Bush up by? He was up by like fucking eight or six or something with like two holes to go. And I beat him. Fucking pressure. And I go, don't pull a fucking Bush here, you know? And so Faust had one bad hole at the end, and it was the one before the end, right? Was it second to last?
I was about to look at the fucking scorecard right now.
It was the one, there was the river run through it, and then Faust, because you're like, well, don't fuck, and we're all wondering, because it's pretty far, but you go, second shot, do I just go for this fucker? Because it's a good shot, and if you fuck up, you're in the river and fucked, or you could go like, I got to go for it, because these motherfuckers will fuck me, right? So Fauci go to the second part of it to get over there, but he didn't get in the water. But he hurt himself. He got in the sand trap, but didn't fuck himself in the sand trap. Got out of the sand trap with a rocket shot, though. One of those sculled. And it goes right into a fucking, it's not even a bush. It's a fucking, I don't even, it's like a fucking a flower bed.
Some sort of shrubbery.
A shrubbery. And it's right, like, we all see it go, and we're next to it. It's not far away from us. Mm-hmm. It's over the thing, over the green, into another one. All right, you gotta find. I'm helping him. I go, we'll feel it eventually. It fucking Bermuda triangled. It fucking went away. We looked for 5 minutes. We're like, it's gone. Okay, it's fucking gone. So
meanwhile, the group behind you is in hole number two.
No.
That 2:30 group, yeah. Oh fuck.
Yeah, there ended up being one lady playing behind us by herself. Mm-hmm. And then I think it was like the 17th. All
she
of
took
sudden,
off, right?
Walked back. She was like, fuck this.
And I saw her in a cart, right? We were driving behind her.
Yeah, it was
was that hole with the sand. Mm-hmm. So we went there and did this and finished out, and Faust had a stroke, this and that. He went, I can't believe I'm losing. So
yeah, that had to be 17 because I had a nine.
That was
only nine of the day.
That did it. Yes. I had one real shithole. Like, I lost a lot of balls and I ended up with a 91. I was pissed. And I'm like, I could have easily broken this fucking 90. And that was the goal at that point, too. And I'm like, motherfucker, of course, a 91. I was like, I got to get a fucking three on the last one to fucking, you know, get this. And I got a four. So we go, we're, you know, hitting toward the clubhouse at the end, and there's a wedding going on. 420 wedding, and you could smell it, and you knew it. So me and Bush are on the green at this point, and Fausti hits one to the green, and the place erupts. And we're like, fuck, I look, I go, what the fuck? And they go, hey, your boy, if he sinks that, that's fucking, I think he said it's par or something. Yeah, I think that's fucking par for him. And I go, no, he fucked up back there. And they go, oh, he goes, never mind, I'll go get a beer. And he fucking, and meanwhile, I'm like, I fucking landed on the motherfucker on two, and he didn't know. I'm like, these motherfuckers don't cheer me, how dare you? So I'm like, I'm putting for birdie, which it wasn't terribly, I would say 10 feet, 10, 12. Yeah, it was off to the side of it. It was pretty even with it. But of course, you come up, you know, cab dick short. And I'm like, all right, so I sink it. But I turned it up because they're watching. So now you have an audience of putting. And I made sure I turned right to them. And I went like that. Four, bitch. And they went, oh.
Four horsemen.
Yeah. Right, I was like, I got a crimp in my hand. So, but along the way, we're looking at all fucking houses along the sides of the fucking place, and they're spectacular. And I'm like, man, these golf course houses, I mean, they're fucking big and nice. Very big, very nice. And so then I decide, I go, let's go to the realtor app and look at the prices. These got to be billion fucking dollars, right? And they're not. They're 700, I see some in the sixes. Mm. And I'm like, these are fucking nice houses. Greg, guess who's going there on Friday to look at buying a house?
You and Duchess.
Thank you. Friday appointment. The house I'm looking at has a putting green in the yard. 3-car garage. So I have, and I had told the Duchess, I said, I don't need, because we want a spare room for guests. Right now, yeah. She has her craft room. I have this one with nonsense. And you do an inflatable mattress. Somebody comes over, whatever.
Or futon or something.
No, I'm not putting anything in this freaking room. And her room's right. Jam-packed. So I said, if I have full garage, all my bullshit. And she goes, but your podcast stuff. And I go, in the fucking garage. I don't give a fuck. And so I'm like, okay. And so she's like, all right. And so we're looking at a three-bedroom place. And 3-car garage, 2-car garage separate from the 1-car garage. I go, ugh, that's the fucking place to be. So golf studio, bear cave with fucking 20 TVs fucking wrapped around the place, podcast, everything, that fucking room. So that's being looked at. Also, going to go look at a house probably in Tracy. Because I was looking up, I said, well, if we're willing to do this here, I go, look at Civilization as well. So I'm, you know how I am very much. You guys know how the fuck I am. If I'm Veruca Salt when it comes to something, you know, if I want it, that's, I'm done. I don't care. I will move heaven and earth. I will have what I fucking want. So I'm trying to stop with that shit because all it does is get me fucking in trouble. You can't be. I'm getting this. I don't give a fuck about anything else. And you're fucked with a bill, whatever the fuck it is. So I'm like, well, I would like to look around. Let's, you fall in love with a place. It's a lot different. You go, well, I'm in love. I don't give a shit. So looking at that and then looking at Civilization of Tracy. In Tracy, there's one, it has a pool and it's like $750 for that with a pool. And I'm like, fuck. And it's in a good neighborhood. Like, you look at, well, let me see the map of what's shit and what's not. That's the first thing you fucking do. And it was in the bright, nice area. So I
don't
want
too many pawn stores around.
No, pawn none shops. Of that. Yeah. That is Upper Tracy, apparently. Because I look at the map and it was like glowing red at the top. And like, I'm in dark green. So I'm like, okay, it's very lush. Green, I guess it was, there's where the money go. So we're going to go look at that. And so I'm looking at, I was looking at the prices for membership at the golf thing. So here'd be the thing. I literally live on, I'll send you the link to the thing, Greg, so you could take a look while we're shooting the shit here about what it looks like. And when they show the upper view from it,
yeah,
is where you see the golf course. It is not on the golf course. It is across the street is the golf course in your little cul-de-sac town. So you're not going to get hit by a ball, at least. And there's another one that is, that we are looking at, because we're looking at multiple over there. But like that's our favorite one. We don't like the outside of how the house looks. Meanwhile, it has everything you fucking need. You know, I'm like, fuck, you know, I'm like, yeah. It got everything though.
Something about the aesthetics on the outside. You yeah, still want it to, you know,
it's always that
something to look at when you come home.
Yeah. And I'm like, I like to look inside the house more so far.
Yeah,
I do. Yeah. House could look great on the outside and the inside's a fucking shell. Right. So I'm like, so there's another one that was like, it said 2-bedroom, but it was enormous. Right. Mm. And so, but one room looks like a fucking rec room where she could make that her thing. And it's a doors that close. I go, that's another fucking, it's a room. So that would be for that. And that's, then it's officially 3, you know, bedrooms.
Jesus, so, this kitchen is fucking awesome.
Yeah, it's fucking pretty. I'm like, no fucking house where I'm like, holy shit. When I see the putting green outside and the rest of the lawn is fake grass, which I love. I love a fake grass. It doesn't, it reminds me of Arizona because of the stone in the front. I'm like, it's very Arizona-ish to me. The only problem with Incomparable, it's fucking hot as fuck in the summertime. You get cooked. However, this is a mile, maybe 2 miles from the lake house. So Well, there we go. Jumping a fucking, you know, in the water. But you look at all the shit that you get in gated community. And let me go to Whiteville, excuse me. And if you want to join the golf club, because I went there to ask, this is when everything fucking went down, because I went to go get some merch. I need some tchotchkes. And I was like, so how much is everything to sign up? And they said, normally it's $1,300 to sign, like your initiation fee, whatever the start. And then, but they said, oh, until June, it's $250 to sign up. I'm like, all right, so if I'm doing this, I'm getting in before June. And they say it's $350 a month for the golf club membership. And I said, well, what the fuck does that get you? And they said, unlimited golf. And I was like, so every day after work, you can go, I'm doing 9 holes at 3 o'clock. Let me jump on the fucking thing and just go. They said the only thing it doesn't include is a cart, golf cart. So I'm like, if you lived in that complex, you would buy a golf cart, you know, for $3,000 and fucking ride around the fucking neighborhood.
Yeah, I saw one of the pictures you sent me of the houses. There was a golf cart.
In the garage, they had one. I'm like, fuck.
In the single part, right? The single car garage, yes. Had a golf cart.
That's where her car would go anyway. So she's off to the side. But I'm like, oh, fuck. But then, like I said, I was like, still in nowhere. You are, Fausto, what I equate it to was The Walking Dead. Remember they got to a nice complex that was caged out? Mm-hmm. I'm in a great community. Fucking fantastic. Don't go outside that fucking place. You go outside, you're not find anything. So it's like,
what's in that little downtown area? Is there like a
there's
store a couple, there
there's
too?
Some I saw restaurants.
I saw there's like a bar and grill. A
there
coffee
is.
Shop.
Yeah. There's that kind of stuff. And there's no Safeway. There's the Payless grocery store that I service to, but it's full. It's not a little, oh, they don't have this here. It's everything.
Right.
They keep
you're
everything
gonna get
at
your
least.
Basic necessities.
You will get, and more so even, I think, you know, so they won't have a sushi bar over there. So, but I'm like, all right, so you look at, all right, what's the time to go to work in this net? It is a half hour less. And at this point, I'm grabbing and clawing for any minute less that I could fucking do. So it's an hour and a half of a drive to Milpitas instead of two. At 2 a.m. So I'd be able to leave the house at 3 a.m. Isn't that nice? Instead, you know, 2:30 a.m. So I'm like, okay, we could do that. And then at the same time, you look at the Tracy stuff, and you're like, well, that's real, real life right there. I'll send you a picture of that one.
Real, real city.
That is a real city right there. I don't know about city. I mean, it's
Town that's still town. Growing. It's still growing with all the people that are moving.
Yeah.
There.
Township. And then, so at the same time, you go, all right, well, this place would go up in price eventually, because we're figuring that fucking thing's going to be, you know, a million real quick with California and everybody moving that way and all that kind of shit, right? So you go, all right, well, it's going to increase. And you go, would Tracy increase quicker and more? Because that's people that don't want to go into the fucking hills, and you're getting a fucking, you know, full thing. So
got a nicer front.
Yeah. The look at the front of the house thing. Yeah. That looks like a regular real house. The other one is a one story. So it's a big puzzle piece of wide.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm like, I do like no stairs after falling down them. I like no stairs. That was fucking horrible. Oh my God. I have not. Every time I step on that top step with new socks on, I go, oh fuck. But yeah, that's the fucking plan at this point. And we'll see what happens, and I'll have updates on next week to see. I'm like, it could happen as quick as that. It could be next week you see these things off the wall behind me. Like packing time. Which is good.
The original plan was next year, right? 26?
25.
Was
that's
20?
Next year.
25,
next year.
That is next year. 26? Yeah, and that was a thing, and I was always laughed at about that I said, the great drive of 2025.
That's right.
And so the thing is, you know, Big Andy would help do the bridge to where you don't have to get rid of this the second that you're getting it. I'm like, that's always the worst, is I got to do 1 foot from, you know, it's the Captain Jack, right, Faust? You step on the other boat as the one sinks. And so it's like, oh, we could start to move shit in there every weekend. And then this place is hollow. And then you could do some of the touch-ups that you need to do with carpet and repair of anything in the fucking house. And then you sell it because it, quote-unquote, I have to be here till October. So in name, we'll be here till October because then it's 2 years. Otherwise, you get fucked on a tax. You're forced to be somewhere for 2 years. Otherwise, they know you're flipping your fucking house. So, yeah, so that's the fucking... That's the Iggy at this fucking point, and see what we fucking do. So I'm like, yeah, there's, I mean, they got full fucking gym, spa, fucking, you know, with the golf and the tennis courts, fucking everything, you know? So you're like, oh, that's a fucking nice, you know.
You don't need a buddy to give a presentation to get you in, like your Lori Loughlin or anything.
All right, so I don't need to have her in there and pay off anybody to get in. Which is great. So, yeah, we'll fucking, we'll see. We'll see how it goes. Because that fee of, you go, all right, well, that's $350 a month for the golf. And then you're doing $99 on the fucking health club or, you know, so you're like, I don't know. You start to go, well, do I need to even do the golf one? Mm-hmm. Because I have the sim at home. I don't know if I'm jumping on that course every fucking day of the fucking week.
To make it worthwhile, yeah.
Yeah. So really, you could kind of do that later and go, well, yeah, I'm out here all the time, so now I might as well fucking go, you know, do it. And then...
Do they have like a part-time, like a summer month
subscription? I don't, no, as far as I know, no.
They have that out here at some of the golf clubs. Like, you could just do like a certain... It costs more for like
the good time.
The form... Yeah, the four winter months. Mm-hmm.
But yeah, the winter for you.
The summer months are fucking cheap.
Yeah. Yeah, the summer months. I was like, when it was 115 out here, that was the first time I ever went there, not to play, but to go like for work stuff. Yeah. And I asked them, so, because I was like, there's not a car in that fucking parking lot. And they were like, yeah, it's $75 on these days. You know, and I'm like, I'm surprised it's still that much because nobody, you're like, fuck you. But I was like, well, if you can handle it, that's the time to go out there and just, you know, hey, I'm by myself. I can do whatever
drink
I want.
Drink a lot of water.
Yeah. Here's a story from that before
the water station.
There you go. Before we move on to the draft, I got one fantastic story, Fauci, which I forgot to tell you, and I'm glad I did so I could tell it on the show instead. I am there buying my tchotchkes. Mm-hmm. And the guy who's working there tells me a story. And I go, we were here Saturday. And I'm telling him the whole thing. Yeah. He goes, you know that wedding that was going on? They're way into 420, apparently. He said, he goes, the wedding was on 420 and the wedding was exactly at 420. So they were way fucking trash, right? So I go, okay. And he goes, my wife was in the bathroom at the time the bride and the bridesmaids went into the bathroom. It's the greatest. Faust, it's the greatest. This is ET realm right here, Faust. And here's them talking, and one of the bridesmaids goes to the bride, I can't fucking believe you had your wedding today on a Saturday on 420. I should be on a fucking pole somewhere being able to make my money.
Oh, wow.
She took the day off to go to the wedding, Faust. Where she should have been at the Pink Poodle. Oh, I was like, oh my God. So that was real fucking interesting to me. So yeah, that's and I said, you know what? We saw a couple people there. That makes sense then, Faust, from the people that we saw walking around.
Right.
Did they have clear heels on?
We didn't get that far down to notice.
Oh, okay.
So the draft is going on this week, kids. And let's say we can go through a couple of things here and what people have for their mocking.
And I can go through the odds for each, top five picks.
Okay, so what is the minus $8 billion for Caleb Williams going number one?
Yeah, I'm scrolling there right now.
And look at
Caleb
this.
Williams, yeah, it's minus 20,000.
Minus 20,000. Holy shit. What does that give you then? Like if you bet, you know, $100, what does that give you?
Here, let me.
A couple cents?
I'll do it right now. I could.
We got to bet 20,000 to win 100.
If you bet $100, you win 50 cents.
I almost Let's think do about it. Doing it for Free fun. Money. For fun, yeah. It'd be funny to fucking win. But look at this. Faust, tell me, don't fuck it up now.
Oh, shit.
Don't fuck it up.
Uh-oh. At least it's not a tattoo.
Jesus Christ. Yeah, this is Super Bowl champs on it.
He just send that to Africa if it doesn't, they'll pick him to the kids.
Yeah, I
he
was like,
he wants to wear number one.
I was like, yeah, I'm that's more the problem. I go, watch him not wear 13 because Allen wears 13 and he'll be like, oh, he's a veteran. I let him have it like a nice guy. Mm-hmm. No, no, you're there forever. Wear your fucking proper number. Give it
at least 5 years.
Thank you. Thank you, Justin. Oh, fuck. Justin's there with 4.
4 years.
Yeah. So, all right. Well, I think it's pretty much a guarantee we're going to get the Bears to take that. See, and now what's funny is I look at the mock draft that people have out, and right away I see they have Drake May at number 2. I don't think Drake May goes number 2. Hmm. I think Jaden Daniels goes number 2. And I think Drake May goes number 3, which is perfect because he doesn't like blacks and he's going to go to New England first. Well, you saw that whole thing. He doesn't follow any black quarterback or any.
That's right. Yeah.
Every Twitter, he followed every white. That fucking one. What's the odds for those? For
Jaden Daniels is -390, and Drake May is +370.
Yeah. See, that makes. Yeah, they're not going to do that. On this draft, this is CBS's fucking mock draft. They are out of their mind. They have, so it is Drake May 2. Then they have McCarthy going 3. Which, I do like McCarthy. I will say I like the guy. You cannot risk the fucking 3. And I said, well, they'll go, hey, we did fine with another Michigan quarterback, didn't we? You know, one of those deals. But come on.
Top 10, maybe, not top 3.
Yes, top 10. You know where he's going is Minnesota. That's my whole. I think he's going to Minnesota, and I'm going to see him every fucking year. And that's at, what, 12? So they might jump a little bit to get somewhere. They have number 4 being Jaden Daniels to New York. And it says they traded Arizona. So Arizona is 3. And I'm thinking, I'm like, how is Arizona not taking Harrison? I don't know that that's possible, that they don't take Harrison.
Well, maybe they are expecting Arizona to trade back or trade down. Because someone would want either McDaniels or May, whoever's left over.
See, they have here's this is where it gets goofy. That's why I had to get the real order, because I'm like, who the fuck? It was number 4 is now from Arizona is the Giants. And then number 5 is the Cardinals from the Chargers, putting the Chargers number 6 from the Cardinals. Like, what the fuck is going on here, man? So I don't know if they would be moving around that fucking much.
Yeah, because they have the odds are -220 for Drake May to go 3rd. So they expect someone to trade up to 3, I think.
And I laugh because people have said, oh, they will have, New England needs 5 billion things, so they'll do this or that. And I'm like, they need a quarterback fucking badly. They have, is it Charcoal Brissett? Is who the fucking quarterback is?
I couldn't tell you who they're.
I think it is now. I think that's who they got, like, for the little bridge. But I'm like, what the fuck? So they're, maybe they get Harrison Jr. at 3 for him. I'm like, well, they're not doing anything. And a quarterback does a lot more than a fucking, I don't care who's your wide receiver, you know. They can be fucking fantastic. It'll be a problem. So I would say at 4, we're getting Harrison Jr. 5
he's
is
the odds on favorite for 4. Okay.
5
-240.
5 is where I think could be the trade with the Chargers, which is funny because you would think I have not seen where the Chargers take like Malik Nabers, which they have no fucking receivers now.
Right.
How are they not getting a fucking receiver? Mm-hmm. Unless it is a very deep class. On round 2, you could still get a fucking pretty decent one. So maybe I would think they're getting the offensive lineman then Alt at 4.
I was reading on The Athletic. They have some scouts in veteran NFL receivers coaches that like Neighbors better than Harrison.
You know,
because he's pure speed.
Here's the problem. Now I heard. So listening to, there is a guy, EJ something, and this guy Manuel. Fucking EJ Man. I know it was always in my fucking tongue when I was going to say it too. And he fucking does all these things, and he's got that insider people where he hears from multiple people. He says the thing he has heard is the issues with Neighbors is not an off the field problem and on the field fine, this and that. He has the Stephon Diggs in him where it is crybaby, hands on hips,
prima donna,
cantankerous type of shit where I'm like, yeah, who needs that? But they go, skill wise, he's right there with fucking madness, you know, to be great. So I'm saying, you want to watch a fucking nightmare? Watch when New York drafts him number fucking six, and you have Danny Dimes, who's his quarterback, and he's pouting all the way back to the fucking huddle. You're going to see some shit right there. Number seven is the Tennessee Titans, which is it offensive lineman is what they're looking at? Is that what's highest?
They have him, yeah, Joe Alt, minus 140.
What did they have for Chargers? Who was the odds?
They don't have by team. They just have by position.
It just has a position?
Draft position.
Oh.
First, second, third,
okay,
fourth,
well, what's pick. Fifth then?
Fifth pick was, Malik Neighbors.
So they had
plus 230.
So then what was six?
Six is Malik Neighbors as well.
There you go. Okay. All right. So,
Odunze is also number two on the second overall for number six. So it's either they say a wide receiver is going six.
Mm-hmm. So then, so I'm thinking there's an offensive lineman that's going for seventh here.
Yeah. And he's Joe Alt's favorite at minus 140.
See, but I think Alt has already gone at the Chargers pick. So that's the thing. If the Chargers get the fuck out of there, it's somebody trading up for a quarterback. And that's going to be the fucking what makes a lot of shit fall around, you know, because it's that reach for somebody else. God. Then you have right here, the fucking Falcons are at eight, which I'm guessing a pass rusher of some sort.
Number eight, they have, how do you say this? Leaitu?
Oh, yeah. Latu. He had a fucking, they told him he'd never play again because he broke his neck. And he's the best guy in the draft. And everyone's like, he's a fucking monster. But you're always terrified. Oh, fuck, he broke his fuck. He's going to have one fucking issue and it's done. You know, one of those. But this was like ages ago and he played multiple seasons in college since. So, I mean, it's one of those. Then, this is where I have the Bears. Number nine, and I want this goddamn Odunze. That's who I fucking want. That's who I fucking want.
They have him favored.
Yes. Him and Caleb are already like buddies. Like, they were fucking around in the plane today. He said, Caleb tweets, oh, shit, Odunze's on my fucking plane to Detroit. And then Odunze fucking tweets back, I'm actually the pilot. Don't worry, I'll get him there safely. Said already playing around with each other.
Pac-12.
And they were fucking around at the combine too. But when I saw Odunze at the combine is when I fell in love because he stayed after the shit was done because he wanted to get a better time on a shuttle drill where it didn't count, but he just wanted to break his time on it. I'm like, oh, that's I like a guy who's out there to bust his ass and work. So, and he's not a give-me-the-ball guy. Neither is fucking Moore, and neither is Allen. I'm like, oh, three fucking monsters like that? That is some major fucking shit. So I would say on my thing is if he's not there, then it's Alt. If Alt isn't there, then it is trade back. You trade back, fuck, at the fucking worst, two, three spots maybe. Maybe you could trade back to the Broncos 12. I think the Broncos are going to be probably the worst fucking team in the league this year. But I go, they don't have a quarterback, and they're trading for garbage quarterback.
They got garbage. Zach Wilson.
They got someone else's trash. I'm like,
they got those new uniforms.
Yeah, that'll look nice in a loss column. Fuck.
0-17, but it would look great.
Fuck. I'm like, wow, that's fucking horrific. So I would think they would be trying to make a move. Maybe they do try to make a move and mortgage the fuck out of their future and go, give me number three. Mm-hmm. And take who either Jaden or fucking Drake, whoever the hell's there, left. But I don't know how New England fucking stops that. Number 10, I saw they were saying for the Jets that it was going to be Bowers, Brock Bowers. What do you got there, Greg?
Yeah, that's the odds-on favorite at plus 145.
I didn't like. I thought he should get a fucking offensive lineman for Rodgers. Mm-hmm. If a guy's fucking, you know, dying out there. Then you have 11 is Minnesota, which is where I think J.J. McCarthy is going to Minnesota. Let's see what that mock draft had for them. This goofy fucking thing. With all their moving around. Oh, they had them move up to 8 and take Penix Jr., which, good luck to you. Good fucking
luck. Yeah, I'm
not
a fan of Penix Jr., especially when
he's too skinny. He's going to get hurt.
That one game, not even the national championship game, but I think it was the conference championship game when he couldn't watch the kicker, so he hit his fucking head like an ostrich in that fucking box. I'm like, what the fuck is this guy?
They have the Broncos. Let's see. The Broncos moved out with the Cardinals at 12. So where the fuck? Did they move up to get somebody? No. So where the fuck did that fucking go? Like they go, let me get out of the first round. We're horrible. We don't need a fucking pick. What is that? That's fucking nuts. Yeah. Let me see. Just keep on scrolling. Oh, here they go. They traded to 27 and got Bo Nix. You know, here's the scary thing. I talked to my my mailman, who's a SC fan, and I'm like, oh my god, I can't fucking wait to have Caleb Williams. I saved this tape for us. I can't wait to have a superstar Caleb Williams. And he goes, I go, what do you mean? He goes, I don't think he's gonna be good in the NFL. I think you know, he tries to do too much. And I go, the team led up 45 points a game. What do you expect? He has to fucking try to throw fucking touchdowns all day. This time he goes, you score 21, you can fucking relax. Go, Jesus Christ, scoring 50 and he loses.
He's got the tools. I mean, that's fucking what makes him such a coveted draft pick. Not because he didn't have the wins, but that's because he didn't have anything around him.
God,
I just can't wait to hear OB yell about his fucking fingernail polish.
It'll be when he loses, he'll yell about the fingernail pop. Faust, he wins, OB paint his nails. I bet you they even put that on a show. OB, if we go to Super Bowl, you paint your nails like he would sing that song if they won the fucking Nationwide's on your side, right? He would never, he's like, I'm not
OB's living that long.
How dare you, Faust? Dare you? We're only talking 2 years here, Faust. 2 to 3 at most. If I can, can he hang on for that? Let's see. The Broncos got to get a fucking quarterback. I don't know how that's fucking possible. So let's scroll to you, because I always heard what you, aren't they talking Kool-Aid for you? You drinking the Kool-Aid?
I saw that on one mock draft,
And the thing for him, too, is that he was like, I guess last year, if he would have came out, he would have been top 10. Mm. Oh, on the CBS, they have cool Kool-Aid out here. Which is good, because he was one of those that was way higher. And now you go, oh, good, you had a little off year. Good, I get you now. Where if this was last year, it's fine. So, and then Kansas City takes an offensive lineman. They have offensive tackle for Mims. They have for... what's it called? For the Dallas Cowboys, which they say every time they go, this Dallas Cowboys, every fucking time they draft an offensive lineman, which makes the crowd go, because it's not flash. I need a jersey of somebody, right? Like the Bears got last year. And I go, I know it's necessary, but it's never fun. You go, eh. Meanwhile, that's how you build a fucking team. But they go, Dallas has hit on every goddamn offensive lineman they ever fucking pick. It's like they have one monster after another. So I heard this morning they were talking about possibly doing getting a center. And that was another guy that the Bears were talking about, that Powers Johnson. Jackson Powers Johnson, I believe his name is. And
he's got a powerful Johnson.
Ooh, wee. He was supposed to be a fucking monster center. And in the first round, they don't have him going.
Yeah, he's not even on the first offensive lineman picked odds.
Well, that's lineman. Center's different, though, than left tackle, really? You know? Oh, God.
As far as center. I'm just talking about offensive
lineman at all. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, you'd take a left tackle. You'd take all 12 times over the fucking center. But meanwhile, motherfucker, I got to hand you the ball every fucking time. And I've known for the last couple of years, fucking Bears have had garbage center. The ball shooting over fucking Fields' head. It was fucking ugly. That's why they traded for Buffalo center, to try to fucking get something going on. But in polls, I trust. And hopefully he does. I was like, I don't want Jared Verse, the edge. I don't want Brock Bowers, because you have fucking your tight end already, even though it's two different types of tight end. You know, there's the fucking YDU, all that shit. But I'm like, anything else? I mean, obviously, they're not going to get a linebacker, but anything reasonably else, as in offensive lineman, a different wide receiver, a defensive tackle, Murphy, who's going to be fucking great, you know, an edge. I'm fine with all those. It's like, at that point, it's found fucking money, you know? So I would like Odunze if he's there. A part of me almost goes, I hope these people are gone so they do have to trade back.
Yeah.
But at some point, you go, let's stop going. Let's keep getting more picks. Let's take the gold that's in front of you and fucking be done with it. Just take what you can. I see Rice's kid is ranked pretty fucking low. Well, he's in the second round, like later second round or mid. He's mid second round. So that's got to be a rough one, too. That's like Jeffrey Jordan. I mean, what the fuck? Good luck.
Right.
Great. Good luck to you, kid. So, all right, let's go over to, is there anything else from the draft that you guys want to even fucking touch on? Because you guys go so late, and I don't know if you even give a fuck about the draft.
And they have a lot of late picks, so I expect...
This is not the draft to have late picks, they say, at all. Yeah. Like, they go, get rid of
them. Maybe, you know, trade up here and there.
And then it's who the fuck wants those late picks. That's the problem. You're going to trade to who when they go, I don't want that shit.
Or they get rid of them and for like picks next year or something.
Yeah. Yeah. Cause I'm like, I don't care about anything after like fourth round is when you're really, you know, and they say this draft is top heavy and then it fucking drops.
Hmm.
So I'm like, okay, well, Bears don't have a second round pick. That's what kind of makes me go, fuck, I would like to have a second round in here, but
their second round pick's ninth overall, right?
Yeah, there you go. That's the second pick. Their second round pick is actually sweet, Faust, as OB would say. Montez Sweet.
No.
Montez Sweet.
Yeah, so I go, I think it that way. I go, okay, well, their second round pick is Montez Sweat. Not too fucking bad of a pick. Yeah. So they'll see if they fucking... Part of me even thinks, watch them trade up to fucking get Marvin Harrison and go, next year we'll give away fucking what a two. And it'd be Carolina's two to fucking jump from nine to fucking four, you know, with the, it'd have to be with the fucking Chargers. Cause I don't think that's if Arizona says, fuck it. And then you get a monster. But I always say, I go, fucking, is Neighbors and Odunze that fucking far away from Harrison that you need to give up all this to fucking get him? I'm like, I don't think it's that fucking crazy of a difference. It wasn't like he's Randy Moss out there. He was more, like I said on that show, Fausto, you heard, that he's more Jerry Rice, that he's precision and route running and good hands. He's not going to be, you've been mossed over anybody.
You've been mossed.
You've been mossed, bitch. So, all right, everybody, have a happy draft. We're going to go over and talk about a movie that Faust picked, which I have to talk to Faust about.
All right.
So that's it. Make sure you sign up to Lingus Mafia. You go to patreon.com/LingusMafia and get all of your nonsensical needs. That's what you got to fucking do here. And that's it. Follow us. You're going to go to Creative Control Network and listen to the Wrestle Lingus show. You could hear us all over there.
Talk about some wrestling.
Yeah, exactly. So let me see. What can I find here for us? Oh, we talked about fucking OB. I can end it with a nice OB there. All right, kids. We'll see you over there.
You idiot!
Go, Pat. Go the fuck home.
Okay. Got a nice medley, Faust. Got a nice medley. Let me call my boss real quick while you guys continue on, because I'm like, I fucking messaged. We're done for the day. There's the phone call. There's a fucking phone call.
Always.
There it is.
Exactly. So I will be right back. I'll do it right here. Just turn my shit down. I'll be right.
Faust, what's up with the Giants, man? Sometimes they're doing great. Sometimes they can't score a fucking run.
they can't do shit right now, though, right? Fucking fall apart for me now. I don't want these. Fuck this. I go every time.
Great. And have with you the seen
Snell,
their...
I think Snell is the big fucking question mark. What the hell?
Well, no spring training. He's notoriously a slow starter, so we'll see what happens.
All right.
He's a second half pitcher. If the Giants can stay close in the second half, they have him, and they're getting oh, shit. Who's the other guy they traded for that's supposed to be back around the All-Star break? I can't think of his name off the top of my head, but he's pretty good. Robbie Ray. Did you see the new light show? They put in new lights, and it's funny because they haven't hit a home. It took forever to hit a home run, so they finally got to, like, blast.
No, I haven't.
I think it was Friday night.
I'll have to look it up.
It's different, but I'm like, fucking Dodgers did this first. That's the only thing that bothers me. It's like, I know the Dodgers do this. The Dodgers is actually better because they have, like, the lights. The main lights go down, and then it's like all these flashy lights, you know, and someone hits a home run. And so now the Giants are doing that shit. And then last night was the first time when Camilo Duvall came in, which is not even as exciting when it's not a save situation. But he comes in, all the lights go down, and they got, like, four spotlights that are on him, and it just follows him out to the mound.
Oh, okay. Oh, yeah.
Music. Yeah.
He only has three saves so far this year, right?
Yeah, he hasn't had opportunities. It's either with winning by a lot or losing. Yeah. So I don't know. They, like you said, they look good at times, and then they're just, what the fuck? I'm saying, I almost in the group when, you know, when, like, Cavson's over his picks, you know, like, all right, so and so money line. I almost put, like, for tonight, because Webb's pitching, I almost put Giants ML. And they say, who sent that? I was going to put at Walnuts Wins.
Walnuts Wins.
But I won't be wrong. Because they don't ever score for Webb. I think the last game was the first time while they scored a lot for Webb. I say if the Giants win tonight, though, there's no way they're sweeping. I say we put money on the Mets tomorrow, especially with what's his name on the mound tomorrow, too? Snell. Snellzilla.
Yeah, what are the odds right now?
With like 11 something.
Oof, I know, fucking A. Giants. Oh, that's Wednesday. There it is. -134 right now for the Giants to win.
For tonight?
Yeah, that's the money line. That's not bad. Over under is 7 runs. So,
Yeah, Webb pitched good last game.
Yeah, he did. And I don't know about this Cevento guy, though. Severino. It was small writing. What's his deal?
Yeah, I don't know. We'd have to ask Cav.
Yeah, all right.
How's things in Arizona? Is it getting hot yet?
Actually, we had our first 100-degree day, they said the other day, which is early. It's usually it's like around 89, and it was like around 97 where I was at. Yesterday it's supposed to cool down by this weekend, like into like low 80s, but it's going back up again. Yeah, it's gonna get hot sooner. I just hope we just have some rain this year. We didn't have any rain last year. It was hot and miserable the whole time. At least the rain cools shit down.
I went over to your brother's new house last weekend.
Yeah, he told me he had his first beer with you over there.
He's like, hey, you want to swing by and see my new place? I'm like, all right. I'm like, he's like, it's not like a housewarming or anything. He's like, I'm just putting stuff together. I'm like, all right, I'll bring a beer.
Yeah.
And you don't put anything together? He says, nah, we're going to take off pretty soon.
Yeah, they had a good weekend of moving stuff, and they have stuff in Stockton. They have stuff in Santa Clara. They're just all over the place. They got to bring it in. So I don't know how it's really going, but it's going slow from what I can tell from my side.
Yeah, he was telling me how you guys live there. You like for, he said when we were young, before your parents bought their house. Is that what he said?
Yeah, from when we were born till about 81, I think. That's when my parents bought their house. So like the first 4 or 5 years of our lives, we lived there, and now he's back full circle.
That's funny. Yeah. It's nice. I mean, for like an older house, it's really nice. I like
the setup. It's so big. You'd think it's two stories, but it's only one.
Yeah. I see the high ceilings. Yeah.
But anyway, yeah.
He was showing me the back, how it's like, was a separate house. And then,
oh yeah. Right? Yeah. My uncle's a bachelor pad.
Is that what it was?
Yeah.
And I said, you should put in like a secret door right here, you know, so it doesn't look like it connects to something else, you know, put like a bookcase, you know, where you got to pull the book down and then it slides open so you can get back there.
And then you get the man cave going on.
Yeah.
Yeah. That'd be awesome. And you could do a Instagram video.
There you go. Right. Hey guys, check out my pad. Here's what I got.
Yeah. But he and I are talking about doing a video soon.
Really?
He has his new place. Yeah.
Oh, okay.
So I don't know how that's going to work, but I don't know if we're going to just do YouTube and just, you know, do it and just post it on there, or if I'm going to use Streamlabs like we do here. So not sure. But yeah, we have been talking about doing video for our podcast.
There you go.
So that'll be kind of cool. Mm-hmm. So I've been wanting to do it for a while just to show the beer and the can art. And
yeah.
People have been asking me like, oh, do you have videos? Like, well, we're on YouTube, but it's audio only.
Yeah, I'm surprised how many people watch podcasts, to be honest.
I don't get it. It's not my thing. I barely even listen to them.
I mean, I listen to them when I'm at work.
Yeah,
but it's hard for me to just sit down and watch it. Like, I see how there's this a lot of popular ones that people sit and watch, and I'm like, I mean, I guess it's like watching a talk show in a way, but it's different.
Yeah,
I don't know. And they all seem similar with the setups, and I don't know. I like the ones that effort into, like, if you're gonna have like a video, like if we had the money, I'd love to have like rent out a small office space to like
film shit.
You know what I mean? Instead of like being our living rooms, or if I had my own room, you know, that I could at least put up a green screen or something, so I could make it look like something.
We should do it. If we did it, it'd be like a Howard Stern show. You have Cav is Stern, you're behind the glass, and I'm in the back in the corner in the dark. That'd be great. It looked like when he was on E.
Yeah.
That studio. I like that studio setup.
All dark.
Yeah.
You would have thought, you know, if they knew there was going to be on TV, they'd have like better lighting, but whatever.
I think Howard wanted it because he's always been, he never liked the way he looked. That's why he wore glasses and kept his hair long in front of his face.
Of course. Yeah, hide yourself.
But have you watched it lately since he's been on Sirius? I know it's been like, I don't know, about 10 years now. But
I know he's not in studio all the time. He only comes in studio for certain guests, I think. Because my wife still listens to him. But she's like months behind. She won't listen to everything. She'll kind of like, who's on the show? Let me see what he's talking about and whatever. And so once in a while, she'll show me clips of somebody. I'm like, oh, he was in the studio today? And she said, yeah, some days he comes in.
He's usually just from home?
Yeah, because of COVID, he was like, why go back to the studio? I can stay at home. He sounds just as good from home.
Well, yeah, they put in with the ISBDN line or whatever they call it. So. And then it sounds like crystal clear. Yeah. Mm-hmm. I wonder how much that costs to fucking put in.
Yeah, I don't know. That's what Tom Tolbert does on KMBR now. He hardly ever goes in the studio. And they stream KMBR now live on YouTube. And every once in a while, they'll post clips like from onto Instagram. And you just see Tolbert sitting there like,
I need like
and then the fucking Steve Kerr, we're gonna have him on later. He's just sitting back. You see his cat. It's like fucking watching Cav. He sees cat climbing all over him while he's drinking a beer.
I need a bookcase behind me so I could put like my Lingus Mafia trophies, or I mean, badass trophies. Baseball trophies.
There you go. That's why I'm like, you need a good background. I'm the only one who has a background in this fucking joint. I got a background. Eventually, you're gonna have to cave.
You know, I just buy one of those green fucking belt screens and put it behind me.
You get a Chinese wallpaper and Chinese divider, green, right?
Somewhere.
Yeah, make your own.
Like at a bar, like JD from New York.
There you go. Yeah, fuck, I'm always impressed by it. I go, it fucking looks good to me. I don't know. I'm like, I don't know how he rolls the window down in a fake car. I'm baffled by it. Let's get into our movie of the week, which is from Fausti. And Faust, what do I have to say to you about this movie?
I don't know. What do you have to say?
I do like a Dumb and Dumber. You go do the stupidest shit, and you finally redeem yourself. Fucking fantastic. I was laughing my fucking ass off on Serp. It's my stupid fucking humor. Like, I told you, I've never seen the movie before.
It's
so
Norm dry humor. If you don't like Norm, you're not going to like the movie, because it's a lot of his, like, note to self. That was one of his bits on SNL. You know, he does those.
And it was very, I found that it's that Family Guy type of jokey stuff where you say something and then something shows up or it's a lot of that to me, where they're standing there talking on top of a building and you don't know anything's going on, and he's pissing the whole time off of it. And he's like, are you just pissing off the edge of a building? And oh yeah, sorry. And he zips, you know, it's shit like that.
The guy shows up.
What, you haven't signed up to patreon.com/lingusmafia yet? Not only would you get the second half of this show on time on Tuesdays, you could also go back in our history for over 500 plus shows. Who could forget show number 29, My Hatred for Aaron Rodgers?
Watching this fucking team of mine, this fucking Aaron Rodgers, if the fucking plane went down, I would fucking dance. I don't care. I'm a piece of shit. I don't fucking care. It's just a game. I hate their fucking guts. It's constantly fucking losing to them.
Spit Roasting, a show with Rob, Jeremy, and Fausti Walnuts, where they go over many topics, including farting in front of your wife.
I remember I was on one of the aisles, right? And I farted. I smelt it, and I moved on to the next aisle. And then she walked down that same aisle. And I remember she kind of gave me a look like, oh, what the fuck? Like, out loud, she goes, oh my God, it fucking stinks.
I'm laying in bed on my side, and I farted with a lot of reverb, yeah. You know? The vibration of the air coming out of my ass started trickling down my leg to my foot.
All the way to your foot?
My foot was vibrating. Like, I could feel the vibrations in my last three seconds of that part, I can feel my foot vibrating.
So get on over to patreon.com/lingusmafia and see what you've been missing.
So I was like, ah, fuck it. But you're sleeping with a window open and a fan, trying to fucking get right. And you just can't go to fucking sleep. So that is it, kids. Hope you enjoyed it. Greg, you do a show. I heard about that. Someone once told me.
Cold Brew Podcast. Ooh. Every Friday, brother and I drink beer and talk about beer.
Very good. That's the way to do it. And I'll try to get you on a network one of these days, Greg, so people can hear that fucking show. Cold Brew. Look for it, motherfuckers. Look for it. That's it. Remember, I can do anything I want because my dad is dead. And that includes drafting Caleb Williams. And we'll see you next Tuesday.
You're either Lingus or against us.
Together we're assholes.
Best podcast. Well, alarm time in the world.
I am the best on this microphone. Nobody can touch me.
Yours truly.
I'm done. Show's over. Good day.
Fade to black.